The free upgrade period for Windows 10 is behind us now, and despite some wording that suggested otherwise, Microsoft has drawn lines in the sand between multiple editions of Windows 10: Pro, Home, Enterprise, and Education. But what are these differences? I'm EposVox, helping make tech easier to understand and more fun through free educational videos. Today we're going to be focusing on Windows 10 Home, Pro, and Education to see which version you need to pick up for your needs. We'll be using the comparison charts directly from Microsoft and discussing them within a more practical, realistic expectation set. Let's start with the easy one, Windows 10 Education. Microsoft has partnered with some universities, which just means that school may or may not have bought the appropriate licensing contracts, which gives their students the most robust version of Windows 10 that there is. Education Edition has literally every comparable feature except for Cortana. It's the only version without Cortana 2. Okay. Students will also receive a subscription to Office 2016 for the duration of their enrollment as well, depending on the license. Now that education's out of the way, should you get Home or Pro? For a wide majority of users, the Home Edition will be perfectly fine. It has the vast majority of features that any normal Home users, see how that works, should need. The features limited to the Pro are primarily business infrastructure based. According to Microsoft, Pro gives you the ability to create and join a domain, a specific work or business level network, use BitLocker encryption, which is not something I recommend using anyway, set up group policy management, use remote desktop, though my Windows 10 Home version, two different versions of it, two different computers with it, lets me use this just fine over my home network, so maybe this only applies to over the internet or something, and use Hyper-V virtualization for running virtual machines with better access to your CPU, which, again, I was able to enable in my BIOS on Windows 10 Home, so I'm not sure what's going on with that differentiation there. The Pro version also has Enterprise Mode Internet Explorer, lol, use Windows Store for Business, set up secure trusted boot modes, use wide deployment Windows updates for business, and then use more than 128 gigs of RAM, up to 2 terabytes, which is only going to be a high-end server thing for a long time. Despite this list, for all intents and purposes, the Windows 10 Home is all most people need. I'm a power user and I can still do everything I need to just with Windows 10 Home. Like I said, virtualization and RDP still work fine for me and my CPU doesn't support more than 64 gigs of RAM anyway. But if you're setting up a business network, you'll need Windows 10 Pro or Enterprise. But if that's the case, you're probably not watching this video anyway. Too long didn't watch, you don't need Windows 10 Pro, but if you're attending a university, try to get your hands on a Windows 10 education license. I hope this video was helpful for you. If it was, hit that like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos. I'm EposVox, and I will see you next time.